Hello and a very warm welcome to the channel, where today we're going to be flying as Emirates 349 from Phnom Penh down to Singapore. So this is quite a short flight for the 777, but it will give us an opportunity just to take a further look at getting the FlightFactor 777 version 2 into the air. So we're just going to have a look at the EFB. I'm just going to show you a flow that really works for me. And if it works for you, great. And if you want to take bits of it and go and adapt it for yourself, that's even better. As I'll summarise, you know, it's a really feature-rich way of interacting with your aircraft. And by it, I mean the menu, the EFB, the CDU, etc. So really, you're going to need to find what works for you. But hopefully, this will be a great start, and I'd very much like you to jump on board and fly down to Singapore with me. So let's start using the flows that I use. So from the EFB, I'm going to initialize the flight. And then I'm going to go to external services and just get the data from SimBrief. And then back to the main menu, I'm going to go simplified loading, and I'm going to choose fill from SimBrief. Now note there that that aligns to how I load my aircraft. If you remember before, I've said I don't really care who's sitting where, what they're drinking, etc. It's just these figures that I'm looking at, the zero fuel weight, the total fuel, and then of course we'll refine the zero fuel weight, center of gravity, should we need to do so. I'm then going to go back to airplane and to loading services. Loading service. Now as a quick reminder from the manual, the top two lines here are going to be the responsibility of the cabin crew, and bottom two, cargo and fuel, responsibility of the ground, and therefore you must make communication with the respective services there. So cabin crew, ground crew. Let's just go ahead and push these little sticks here, as I call them, not sticks. So just so that you can see the green light, and then you can hear things. So over here, for example, you'll hear the PA, and to turn the volume down, just do that arrow there further round on the left hand side. So just make contact with the purser, and that's this one here. So let's go and do that, and we're just going to say hello to them.
Hello, this is the captain.
Hi captain, hear you loud and clear.
There we go. So with such a glamorous greeting, we're guaranteed as much coffee and cookies as we want during our flight. So let's just get them to start loading the catering.
The crew and aircraft are now ready for catering to be loaded on board.
Of course, sir.
372 kilos on it, just there. And you can see they're waiting for the catering truck. If you go back to the airplane menu and just click onto ongoing processes overview, you'll see what's currently happening there. So for example, here it's waiting for the catering truck.
We are fueling you, sir.
So I've just gone ahead here and clicked on load fuel, and we'll do the same with load cargo.
We are ready here for the loader.
Okay.
All right, there they go. So little tip, if you actually can't click on those, say if they look like that on this side, it just means that you haven't made those respective communications. Let's just go back to this over ongoing processes, and you can see now there's a lot more things that are taking place. We'll just leave the passengers in the terminal, taking the final sips out of their Starbucks or whatever they've bought. So we'll just go and test the oxygen here. So pre-flight checklist, oxygen
tested 100%.
Flight instruments, I've set the heading to 230, it's our departure runway heading, and QNH 1009, that's both sides.
Set, checklist complete.
Okay, pre-flight checklist done. Okay, so let's get to work then on loading the FMCs. So we can pop those out. Pop them out, just use the click spot there. And let's have a look. So time at the moment, well, it's evening time over in Asia at the moment. And we'll go over to the route page. Go to keyboard entry mode, and we're going to go with BD PP, go to W and 3 S's 01, goes in co-route. Activate that, execute it, and the call sign UAE349, which goes into there.
Thank you very much.
Okay, so I did, when you heard those ding-dongs, that was just the ground calling to say that they're done with the refueling, so switched over to Mike, went over the top line there on call queue, answered the phone, done with refueling. Right, so let's go back to the departures and arrivals page, and departures, runway 23, Condor 2 departure, legs page, let's just see, we've got no discontinuities in there, until we get to Sanat, which is our arrival there, into Singapore. So, zero fuel weight, we've got 174. Reserves is going to be, it's quite high, it's going to be 9.6, but do remember, all you are putting in there is the sum of your alternate plus your final reserves. Like so. 390 is our cruise altitude and cost index is 45. I've just popped out the EFB, which you can do just using this menu, EFB, show, hide the respective EFB there. Let's go back a page and we'll go to loading service and now all the passengers on board, so load those.
You may board the aircraft now.
Yes, sir. We'll ask passengers to board immediately.
I recommend as well that you have a look at the manual to explain how this interface works. You know, from this menu, this is supposed to be the least touch, and then we go down to the FBs where you've kind of got, yeah, you'll need to do a bit more hands-on in order to get things to happen. And then if you want to go right down to the CDU, that's where you're going to be calling for absolutely everything. So if you want the refueling, for example, you'll have to call for the respective fuel trucks as well. So it just depends how sort of granular, if you like, you want that process to be. Won't surprise you, I'm kind of middle in the road. I just want to be able to click a button and say, right, let's get those loaded, let's get the fuel loaded, etc. And on ground, this is Emirates 349 requesting clearance to Singapore with information kilo.
9, information kilo is current. Cleared to Singapore via the Condor 2 departure, then is filed. Departure runway 23, initial climb 13.13000. Departure on 123.8, squawk 4544.
Cleared to Singapore via the Condor 2 departure, and then is filed. Departing runway will be 23. Initial climb, flight level 130, departure frequency 123.8, and we'll squawk 4544 for Emirates 349. So you've heard us get our clearance, sir. Hopefully I've read that back correctly.
Emirates 349, read that correct.
There's a tick in the box. So set the squawk code 4544. We just had a message as well from the person to say that they're done there loading the catering, so you can see that the to load and on board now matches, so that's what you'd expect. The boarding of passengers is still going on, as is the loading of the cargo. As the fueling process is done, we'll go ahead on the seatbelt sights. Just as an FYI, there is a configurable option as well where you can change the time factor of these, so it's just a multiplier if you want to quicken these processes up. Just go and have a look for that in the manual. So we've just got another call here, so we'll go ahead and we'll answer the purser.
I am listening.
Captain, boarding is done.
Thanks.
Okay, so kind of expected that because I saw that the quantities there were now the same. I'm using the Simbrief performance calculator, so this is giving me a DTO2 with a assumed temp there of 52. That's where you access the CG summary as well from, that we were just discussing a moment ago. So we'll just go ahead, we'll set 148 on there. We've got 230 set and 13,000 set on the altitude window. I've popped on the flight directors as well as arming LNAV and VNAV. So with everyone now on board, I'm now going to come down here, go to ground and ground crew.
How can I help you?
You can help me by removing all equipment.
Please remove all ground equipment.
On it, sir.
And then what we'll do, we'll go back to ground crew and
I am here.
We're now going to get them to close any hatches.
Please close all hatches and remove all personnel. We are ready to pressurize the hydraulics.
Clear to pressurize.
And then finally, I'm going to go back to ground crew and just get them
listening
to disconnect.
How can I help you?
We would like to start.
Very well, sir.
Thank you very much.
Till next time.
Very polite, aren't they? I've said to you before to do this, menu, simulation, situations, call it what you want. Call it Chucky Egg, I don't mind. Just save your situations regularly. I'm expecting better pushback to say that they're ready. Let's just see the notes there.
So connected and bypassed in and service. Release parking brake.
Just need to do the before start checklist. So flight deck door, I'll just lock it there.
MCP.
So that's set then with a V2 148 heading 230 and 130.
Set. Takeoff speeds.
They are 139, 142, 148.
Set. CDU preflight.
Complete.
Completed. Completed. Trim.
I set that one.
Set. Taxi and takeoff briefing.
That's
completed.
Completed. The beacon light. See, there, I've not obviously switched it on because it will auto complete that. So beacon
on.
Goes on.
Checklist
and
complete.
I'll go ahead now and switch on the hydraulics. Still need to get my head in the book and make sure that I'm doing that the right way around. Just the left and right centre pumps for today. Just verify that. And right, off we go. So I'll go ahead, I'll release the parking brake.
Starting pushback. And you may start engines.
So engine 2 there is just firing up. And I'm now starting engine 1. Okay, my headset battery went flat, but I think we have captured everything. Just going to dive here first. Airport map, so you get that from menu, airport map. And I didn't actually go to the, I didn't need to go to the IDEM page, it just filled this out for me, it was already there. Okay, so let's just do our after start action. So our pin, okay, so he's just showing us the pin there, that's fine. We'll bring up the checklist then.
Taxi
for
checklist,
the
please. Anti-ice. Set.
Okay, so let's just go ahead then. We're just going to switch off the APU, just there. Verify there on. I'll go now with the taxi light on. And anti-ice. So I'm just going to override that because I'm just going to leave it off. There's no need for the anti-ice.
Recall.
Recall.
Check.
That's been
checked. Flight controls.
Brakes
check.
RTO. It filled that in automatically. Flight controls, let's just bring up the flight control page and I'm just going to do down, neutral, back, and full left, centre, full right, and rudders to the left, centre, rudders to the right. Verify that we've got 4 units of trim. So, checked.
Ground equipment, clear.
Plan.
Cleared, checklist complete.
Phnom Ground, this is Emirates 349, request taxi runway 23. Doors to manual as well, that's not correct. So what we should have done is just called the purser. Should have armed the doors just before we pushed from the stamp, so.
All ears.
Emirates 349, taxi to runway 23 at your discretion.
Yes, sir. All doors are armed and checked.
So I'll just go to the doors page there. You can see they're now set to automatic and they've launched into their safety briefing. So we'll let them do that. Taxi runway 23 at our discretion for Emirates 349. So you can see on the taxi map there, so this is taxiway H just here. I was a bit too aggressive there on the brakes, wasn't I? So we'll just let the speed build up slightly. I'm just using idle power. So 2-3 knots, just give it a bit of up on the left hand engine and bring the nose here into this corner and take taxiway H, and then we're going to be on the runway. So whilst we need to do a backtrack, we do need to put our lights on, of course.
Clear left, clear right.
And just showing you that again, now we're on the runway, just so you can see how that aligns there, how that's represented on the airport map.
Clear left, clear right.
Okay, so we are just completing our backtracking maneuver here.
On runway 23.
So I've done the before takeoff checklist. Just gonna call for clearance. Phnom Tower, this is Emirates 349, runway 23, ready for departure.
Emirates 349, runway 23, winds calm, cleared for takeoff.
Clear for takeoff, runway 23, Emirates 349. Okay, so we are clear for takeoff. Start the chrono and off we go to Singapore. Engine stable. Thruster F. Knots. Potato bake.
3,000 feet remaining.
Positive rates and gear up. Trim down. Thrust ref, VNAV speed. Let's go with the autopilot. Engaged.
Emirates 349, contact departure.
Departure on 123.8 for Emirates 349. Bye bye. So I'll just verify there that the aircraft settled down. Hello departure, it's Emirates 349, Conda to Alpha departure, climbing flight level 130. Flap on.
Emirates 349, Phnom Penh approach, radar contact, cleared direct Conda, climb flight level 200.
Direct Conda and climb flight level 200, Emirates 349. Right, I think we are coming to the end of this video now. So you've seen us do a lot of the prep in the FlightFactor 777 version 2. And, you know, it's such a vast, feature-rich interface, what you've got from either the menu, the EFB, or then being more granular down onto the CDU. So, you know, you do need to find your own flow. You know, I've been fortunate to have this aircraft for quite a while, but I'm only just now getting into my own flow. So do, you know, spend some time. Don't be afraid to make mistakes of who you're calling, who you're going to get your coffee from, who you're going to get your fuel from. But as promised, there will be more content featuring the 777. So if there are any comments, questions, please do drop them in the comments. And until then, do take care, and I'll see you soon on another video. And do like, subscribe. Thank you very much for viewing. Bye bye. Una basi kulisa inesu.